guys. Welcome in. If you're new here, my name's Sterling, and I paint things. Today I'm going to be painting this very, very cute monkey with a very sad expression on his face. Or maybe that's totally just what I'm seeing in him as he chews on a disposable medical mask. I was invited to this collaboration by Lana at LanaGoesArt, and I'll have her link and everyone else's link that's participating in the description. I was really honored to be invited. I knew that she was planning something because she requested any pictures I could find of masks in the environment, discarded and left as litter. And to be honest, I don't leave my house very often, so I hadn't realized what a problem this was. But taking a trip earlier this year, I started taking pictures, and there was zero issue finding subjects to photograph. It was disheartening. I didn't realize what a huge impact our use of a new disposable item would have. We got rid of straws just in time for masks. I felt so fortunate at the time, being someone who has sewn on occasion and quilted, to have all of the materials I needed on hand to make reusable, washable face masks. I of course say this never to vilify anyone that uses these daily, monthly, to protect themselves and others around them. I guess I say that I'm fortunate because it really hadn't occurred to me what an impact a whole new disposable daily use item globally would have on the environment and the animals living in it. And I want to say that I really put a lot of thought into how this would hit the environment and those that live in it. I want to say that I spent a lot of time thinking about ways I could help with the issue. But if I'm being honest, I would say that I'm not as involved in solving and finding solutions as I wish I was. If someone will tell me doing this thing can help, it can make things better, I'll do that thing. I think it all goes back to, if you know better, you do better. And maybe I should look into educating myself further. I so admire Lana. She saw this coming before I had ever even heard it was a problem. She was making masks for coworkers. She was battling the issue head on. Today I'm painting this little guy on an Arches 140-pound block, a 9x12 block, and I'm painting him with my silver black velvet brushes because they just hold the best point and the most water, and I just really, really enjoy them. I'm enjoying arches more than I used to. I was really a huge fan of the Baohong blocks. I ordered many of them from AliExpress, and now that they're available on Amazon, I purchased them there too. And I still love them, but every once in a while, and I don't know if most artists go through this, but I go through phases, and what feels best to me shifts. It'll shift the brushes I use, the paint I use, the paper I use. And my wonderful friend Joy tells me that this is growth and progress. It's a growing pain. And I have to remember that, because sometimes I get frustrated. It feels as though I invest and then I don't use for a good long time things that I used to be crazy about. So I'm trying to keep that in mind as I'm painting on this arches, that my love affair with it may not last. I have been using this ceramic palette I got from Meaden a lot lately. I was looking for something with big wells, because most of my paints are in half pans, and I constantly feel like I'm destroying my brushes using them. So I purchased this, and I filled it with my most used colors. I have Lamp Black at the top, and that's by Renaissance, and I really like their Lamp Black. It's probably my favorite, and I now have 4 or 5 tubes of it, and who knows, I may hate that tomorrow. The next one I have is the Renaissance Polish Brown, and then I have I believe the next one is also Renaissance, their Burnt Umber. I did have a Daniel Smith Burnt Umber, and I recently swatched it out to try and figure out why it really wasn't working for me, and its movement is so stunted compared to other brands. It has a beautiful tone, and it has beautiful granulation, but it doesn't move like I really need it to. So I swapped that out. And I'm going to put the swatches of the Burnt Umber and how it moves up on my Instagram so that you can see that. Because it was shocking to me. Like, it was so evident that people that don't paint could see it. Then we have Burnt Sienna right below that, and I believe that is my personal Burnt Sienna that I made myself. And then we have Ultramarine Blue. I believe that one's Daniel Smith. We have Quinn Rose. That is Daniel Smith. And then Renaissance, I believe. Hold on. And then Renaissance Orange Ochre and Van Gogh's Yellow Ochre. So those are the ones that I have found myself reaching for over and over again. The background color I use here actually isn't part of the palette. It is Daniel Smith's Under the Sea Green. Thank you. I'm going to leave you guys here for today. Thank you so much for watching and hanging out with me while I rambled. Everyone who's part of the collaboration will be listed down below, and I'm sure they'd love to see you there and hear from you. If you enjoyed this, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. Let me know what you want to see next and what you thought of this guy.